Welcome back to Breakfast from Roth. My name is Bob Babbitt. We are at the 30th anniversary of Challenge Roth. And joining us, fresh off of winning her second Ironman World title, Miss Marinda Carfrae, and getting married. It hasn't not much has happened in the last 6 months or so.
Yeah, I'd definitely still say fresh off of. Yes. I think you're allowed to say that for at least the next year, right?
Absolutely. It happened yesterday.
Yeah, totally. Feels like it.
So this race, from talking to Macca and folks like that from over the years for athletes from Australia, they would make a list of St. Croix and Wildflower and Alcatraz and look at the great American races. But Challenge Roth was always on that list for him. Was that for you when you got into the sport?
Yeah, you know, initially it really wasn't. All I really was focused on was Kona, and it wasn't until a couple of years later that I just started hearing about Roth, and every athlete that came back from here was just raving about the event and how great it was. And, of course, a good friend of mine, Belinda Granger,
yes,
has done this race 10 times, and if there's someone who can talk, it's Belinda. So I've heard so much about the event just from her over the years, and after winning Kona last year, I just, you know, as you said, it's kind of a bucket list event.
Right.
And, you know, I want to be able to, you know, race some of the greatest races in the world while I'm still fit and while I'm still, you know, a contender for the title of these races. So it was just a great opportunity for me to come out and race a couple of Challenge Family races. And obviously Roth is the one I really wanted to come out and see what it was all about and just enjoy, you know, the whole atmosphere and there's a freaking amazing field assembled too, so it's going to be a tough day.
I was going to say, you've got Caroline Steffen, defending champion, you got Rachel Joyce, you got Rebecca Keat, Michelle Vesterby. You've got a great, great women's field, which I know you like that. You don't want to go to a race where you're the only pro or there's only a couple of pros who can win the race. Obviously, you want to win, but you also like to go against a good field.
Yeah, absolutely. I think sometimes the lighter fields add more pressure.
Right, yeah.
To come here and perform well could mean a podium, but you're going to have a fantastic day to win. And so it's kind of anyone's race in that regard. Like, you mess something up, then there's going to be another girl there that'll sweep in and take the win. If you're racing against maybe a field that's a bit weaker, then all eyes are on you, and you're expected to win. And if you mess it up, then you kind of you completely mess it up. So I enjoy racing against the tougher fields. I feel it usually gets the best out of me. So hopefully that holds true on Sunday.
So this year, with Kona's coming up in October, how do you build up to this race? Did you build up to this race as an A-list type of race?
You know, after Kona last year, I said, okay, I want to go to Roth and I want to race really fast in Roth. But as the year unfolds, as you know, being a defending champ, you have a lot of extra obligations. You have sponsorship commitments, all great things.
Sure.
And it is tough to focus on training and only training like you do for a championship. So I feel that I'm in very good shape for this race. I'm certainly not in Kona shape, and I wanted to be in Kona shape for this race. So I don't really know. I've never done a full distance event in July. I've always done Kona and then either a late season one in Florida or an early season one in March, New Zealand or Melbourne. Mm-hmm. So this is sort of the first time I've raced mid-year full distance. And, you know, I'm always fit around this time of year, so I don't know. I really don't know how well I'll race on Sunday. I feel that I'm in good shape, but I think time will tell.
When you look at some of the history here with, you know, Chrissy Wellington going 8:19, 8:18, Rebecca Keat going 8:39 and not winning, people go fast here.
Yeah.
If the conditions are good, is that something? Because Ironman is not considered a fast course. Kona is not considered a fast course. This is considered a fast course. Are you looking forward to that?
Absolutely. I mean, who doesn't love going fast?
Yeah.
I'd love to post a fast time here. That being said, though, I rode on the course, and I don't know how those girls ride so fast.
Is that funny?
It is not.
It's not easy.
It's not easy.
Yeah.
I was kind of blown away at, you know, just how it's not like a super difficult course, but you see the times and you expect it to be nice rolling hills, all the hills that you can kind of roll over from the past hill. But there are some good little climbs out there that you're really going to have to work on. So, yeah, I'm kind of surprised that the times have been so fast in the past, but I won't know until I go out there and feel for myself, you know, how the race pans out.
I think
out.
It's funny how races, we have a race in Southern California, Carlsbad 5000. When you run it, you're going, there's two 180-degree turns, there's little rises, yeah. And the guys, every year, you know, guys are running low 13s, and you're going, yeah. How does that happen? It's the competition, yeah. Right? It's the field that comes here, and the mentality of this is a fast race. Mm-hmm. You know, so people just go for it, I think.
Yeah, I guess so. I'm going to have to go for it then.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, when you got here and basically you've been put up in a retirement village and you're playing, when they put you in a retirement village and you're playing bingo with the other guests there, is that a hint that maybe, you know, gosh, Rennie, we think you're a little bit over the hill here. How's that been?
No, it actually has been fantastic. Originally when I was signing up to do this race, Timothy was going to come out, yes, with me, and my mum was planning on coming over as well, but she couldn't get off work, and Timothy, it made more sense for him to stay at home and,
right,
do Racine the same weekend as Roth. He just couldn't find a race out here. So, yeah, now I'm by myself in the retirement village. It's actually a brand new facility. I've got my own apartment.
Bingo?
I would love to be able to play bingo, but I can't speak a word of German. Actually, maybe I've learnt like one or two since I've been here. But honestly, you forget how tough it is when you're in a foreign country,
yes,
like eating food. Like, I'm too nervous to go down to the local bakery and order something because I don't know what to say. So I feel ridiculous pointing, and I feel rude that I don't know the language at all. But people have been really friendly and really kind. And it's been pretty lonely in the retirement village because I kind of just kept to myself. I can't talk to anyone. So
shuffleboard? You haven't found the shuffleboard court yet?
I haven't. I'd like to. Maybe I'll go this afternoon and try and check out the shuffleboard, or I don't know, some of the other games.
You probably don't have to worry about them keeping you up late.
Exactly. Yeah, it's very quiet at the retirement village. They do like to wake up early, though.
I
will say
3-4 in the morning.
Yeah. So I put the earplugs in at around 3 or 4 and try to sleep in.
Nice. So you winning the Ironman twice, holding the course record. I mean, you've pretty much, if you're looking back, you probably, hey, if I win the Ironman once, that's great. So you probably accomplished a lot of what your dreams would have been. Is it getting close to baby time, or what's coming up?
Certainly now that Tim and I are married, you know, there's a common topic about, you know, how do we do this? When,
right,
do we have children? I'm 33 now. I think, you know, it won't be for a few more years yet.
Okay.
I still feel that I can go faster or go better in Kona. I still feel that I've got improvement to go. And while I feel that I think I owe it to myself to continue,
yes,
racing and continue improving. But that's not to say that, you know, maybe we have a child in a couple of years and then I come back to competition.
People come back
stronger.
Good. Yeah, stronger, yeah.
So I can, you know, can only hope. You never know. You know, that kind of completely could change everything.
Right.
It could change everything for the better for my career, or it could change everything for the worse. So it's kind of a gamble, and I don't want to make that gamble until I'm ready to make the next step.
So we're, you know, Siri is here, and she got Rebecca here, and yourself, and with the whole group of women training together, and how does she keep it, you guys, from killing each other, and keeping everybody focused on their own goal and being happy for each other, but also now Jody Swallow's part of it. I mean, you got people who really are, you know, when you're a professional athlete, they're in your way.
Well, yeah, we've got a bunch of alpha dogs, I like to say,
yes,
in the group. But I think the personalities are all very respectful of one another. I mean, you know, Jody, myself, Rebecca, Mary Beth Ellis, you know, we're all out there just trying to, you know, work hard and get the best out of ourselves. We're certainly, you know, not being put head to head in, you know, run sessions or bike sessions, unless it makes sense.
Right. Unless you're pushing each other for a specific,
you know, or unless we're on the wind trainer. But,
right,
for, you know, for the most part, I do all my running, you know, either with one of the guys or by myself. Swimming, we all swim together, which, I mean, is fine.
Yeah,
they're all
deal.
Better than I am in the pool, so
yeah.
I just try and keep up. And then on the bike, she kind of splits us off into groups. So certain personalities work better with certain personalities,
yes,
and, you know, others like to go by themselves. So, yeah, I kind of, Siri has to manage those personalities, and I think she's been doing a very good job of figuring out how to do that and,
yes,
how to get the most out of each athlete.
Yeah.
It's definitely a balancing act, but it seems, I mean, I've really enjoyed working with all the girls this year, and I think there's just a mutual respect amongst the,
sure,
group, for sure. There has to be.
So after this, because you haven't done a mid-season Iron Distance race before, is there some downtime before the build-up to Kona? And will be, you know, in the past, you usually will do a half or a 70.3 about a month before. Same type of situation this year?
Yeah, I always, around this time of year, would take a week off.
Right.
So after this race, it, you know, makes perfect sense to take a week off, recover mentally and physically. So Timothy and I are actually going up into the mountains for a week just to get away.
Yeah.
No bike, no swim, no run, just lots of wine and relaxing. So we'll be doing that for the week after this race, and then we get back into like the serious Kona block of training, and hopefully there'll be minimal distractions in terms of photo shoots and so forth in that block. And then, yeah, I actually might do Hy-Vee this year.
I know, when you finished second in there a couple years ago. That really set you up for a good year.
I really enjoy racing Olympic distance races. I don't know how it will go coming off an Ironman.
No expectations, so. That's
exactly.
Nice.
Exactly. I mean, it's nice to go in and just have a really hard hit out. But again, it'll either be Hy-Vee or Muskoka.
One of those two.
Yeah, those two. So I feel like it's a good plan, and I'm looking forward to checking out this race on Sunday and seeing what the girls have.
So you've had a chance to see Rebecca Keat, and she's gone 8:39 here. Mm-hmm. She's finished second and third. This has been a great race for her. What do you feel that she's going to be up there this time?
Oh, absolutely. Beck's always there or thereabouts. It's just a matter of whether Beck, you know, can get it right on the day.
Yes.
And I think that holds true for all of the girls.
Of course.
I mean, Carolyn, as you said, defending champ. Rachel Joyce, second in Kona.
Yes.
Won this race 2 years ago.
Yep.
I guess the thing that those girls have that I don't is that they've all raced here before. So
that knowledge.
And been successful.
Right.
At the end of the day, you still have to have a fantastic day to win. And it's anyone's game, I think.
Love it. Marina, thanks for, as always, being so generous. I know you have to get back. They have a shuffleboard at like 2 in the afternoon at the retirement village.
Absolutely.
And then they have Jello and all the rest of that stuff for all you retired people.
Yes.
I love that. Marina Carfrey has been our guest again. We are brought to you by Nitro and Flapjacked. Rainer is going to take us out. Check us out. Breakfast from Roth. We'll be back tomorrow. Thanks, everyone.